Enhance your listening experience. VoxWave.com.
Check out all your favorite shows at VoxWave.com. On Mondays, we keep it moving with The Kim Show from 11 to 1 p.m. Then it's time for A Change with Sherry and Mignon, 6:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. And then, In the End We Win with Curtis, 8:15 p.m. to 9:15 p.m. On Tuesdays, 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Start your afternoon with The Wealth Zone with Raymond Starks. Then it's Cooking with Flavors with Chef Flavors, 5:30 to 6:30 p.m. And Treat Yourself Right with My Spa Bath and Body, hosted by Margaret Harris, 7 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. Up next is Slick Daddy Rick, Heartbeat Congo Hour, rocking from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. Then on Wednesdays, you can't miss Impact the World with Cheryl Woods, 12 noon to 2 p.m. And then from 6:30 to 7:30 p.m., we got Slick Talk with Oscar D and It's the Kid. Then from 8 to 9 p.m., we crank it up with Live Set Wednesdays, hosted by Reg Gaskins. And after that, 9:15 to 10:15 p.m., the BGKH Show with Dominion and Epic. And check out our Thursday lineup, starting with You, Math, and Me, hosted by George Randall, from 10 to 10:30 a.m. Then from 7 to 9 p.m., the 6:40 Evening Show with DJ 6:40. And on Fridays, we start out with Peace in the Morning Show with Darius A. Stan, co-host Delicate Daryl Barnes, and Queen of Sudabag, 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. From 10:30 to 11:30, the Hall Street Journal with Robert Hall and co-host Clarence Sanders. And after that, you know we gotta check in with Chanel's 3 Cents, 1:30 p.m. to 2:30 p.m. Up next, from 3 to 4:30 p.m., Daryl Allen Hairston II Crime Victims Foundation Show with your host, Daryl Hairston. Then, from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. is The Rush Hour with DJ Drew and Janique. And from 9:15 to 11:15 p.m., you can't miss Different Minds Show.
Today we have Nassim Sadiq. Did I pronounce it right?
Yes, perfect.
Like Raphael Sadiq, but you spell it a little different.
Just a little different.
Just a little different. A little different. That's what's up, babe. We glad you're here, man. I didn't get a chance to hear you warm up. Usually I get a chance to hear the folks to come in here warm up, man. Right. I didn't hear you warm up, but I know my man Ron said you're good to go.
That's what's up.
You got a sound check and everything, man.
Yes,
so tell me, brother.
Thank you, Ron.
Tell everybody what instruments you play, man. How many instruments do you play, brother?
I play guitar.
Play guitar.
Yes, I can read music, but the instruments I play is guitar.
Now we got another brother in the studio right there, Mr. Sanders. He keeps bongos.
Right.
He can't see him right now. Okay.
Uh-huh.
But he keeps bongos in his back seat.
Ready to
go. He was asking you just now about the bongos. So he go out there and get the bongos. You hit the bongos for us also tonight.
Nah.
Okay, he's going to keep it real. He's going to keep it right in the pocket, right? Well, yeah. Tell us, brother, all jokes aside, how did you get started with the guitar, man? Tell us. Give us the real story.
All right, so what happened, my roommate, he had a friend that came to visit, mm-hmm. and his friend played guitar.
Roommate, college, high school,
no, that
we, elementary school?
No, this is, all right, so a little backstory. I used to be a Spanish teacher.
Okay.
Okay, and then I had a roommate, you know, we had an apartment together.
Okay.
You know, I didn't. That's it. We just had an apartment together. So he had a friend come visit, and his friend left his guitar there for like 2 weeks. So I kept on walking by, and I was looking at it. I was like, yo, let me mess with this thing. So I picked it up.
Okay.
And it was easy for me to figure out how to do like just some simple. Nah, not the riffs, but just some simple melodies by ear.
Really?
So then I was like, you know what? I was like, I want to get my own. So then I got my own guitar, and as soon as I was able to sing and play one song, I was hooked.
What? Hooked. Did you take some lessons or something, man? Did you take some tutorials or something? Did you read some books or you hear some music behind or something? How'd you do this thing, man? How'd you put it together, brother?
So it was on Apple. They, like, for the MacBook, they have GarageBand tutorials on how to play guitar. So that's what taught me how to read the chord diagrams and start to learn how to play the chords.
Mm-hmm.
So once I was able to read the chords, mm-hmm. I went to, like, guitartabs.com, and I just right. was able to play some simple songs, you know, and I challenged myself. And like I said, as soon as I was able to sing and play one song,
right,
hooked.
You know what, man? I'm gonna get an audience, people that are not musicians out there. I'm gonna give them a little education on something. You know, you know how sometimes you see guys come into the audience or from the crowd onto the stage, and they come up there with their instruments, and they're able to play right away, right in tune with that, and sounds real good.
Right.
You understand that, right? What it is, they found out by ear what key they playing in.
Mm-hmm.
The key is C or whatever key they playing in, and each key has so many notes that's in that key. If you stay within those notes, you can play, you can riff, you can do almost anything.
Yep,
so that, to the listening audience, just a little key, you wonder why, how is this guy just come off the break, never practiced with this band, because he finds out what key they playing in,
mm-hmm.
and bam, he fits right in. As long as he stays within that key,
yep.
those eight notes, he's straight. So did your family play any kind of instrument? Did your mom and dad, or you just... You got any kids, bro?
Nah, not yet.
Are you going to teach your kids how to play the guitar if you ever have any kids, brother?
If they're interested in it,
okay.
Yeah. Like,
okay.
If eventually when I do have kids, I just want to support them and whatever,
mm-hmm.
like, they, you know, they aspire to be or what they want. Just,
okay.
Like, just push them to grow with their dream, with their vision.
Well, tell the audience, do you do anything else besides play guitar, bro?
What, I sing.
Some other hobby you sing?
I sing,
are
yeah.
Are you going to sing tonight, too?
Heck yeah.
I mean, I missed the warm-up and everything,
that's what
man.
I'm
you
going
to do a little
for.
Singing
that's what
too
I'm
tonight?
Here for. Let's
you can do
get
a little
it.
Acapella and all that stuff, too?
Acapella.
You can bust out something. So if I ask you to bust out something right now, you can bust me something right
on
now?
On it.
Okay, we're going to ask you to bust something right now. Then.
Right now?
Let's go. Right, the camera right there.
Do. Do for love. You tried everything, but you won't give up. In my world, only you made me do for love what I would not do.
That's what's up, baby.
Yeah,
give it up, baby. Give it up right here on it, baby. Right here on the live set, baby. Right here on the live set. That's what it's all about, is a live set. That's what we call it, a live set.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? That's what we're doing right here tonight. I'm excited.
Yeah.
You know, but look here. We're going to take a quick break. But before we take that quick break, we're going to tell everybody who our sponsor is. Adele Motors, our Star Imports. We're right here, 4711 Arth Place, Suitland, Maryland. Not Maryland, but Suitland, Maryland. Right here, 4711 Arth Place. Okay, we're right inside of a car dealership. And I want to thank these brothers that's behind us, that's dealing with the car dealership, for giving me the opportunity to rent this space right here and do big things. They can find you a car if it's not on the lot. They can find you a car online, get your credit straight, get your money straight, get your finances straight. They can get your car. You can drive away with a smile on your face right here at Del Mo's. You know what I'm saying? You can be stick away. If you can't drive a stick, they get you an automatic. They got mopeds out there, man. You know, they got motorcycles
got the
and mopeds
they got
out there.
Everything.
Yeah, for sure now. But this is what we're doing. We're going to take a break right there. We're going to come back. When you see this brother again, you're going to be singing and playing.
Let's
acoustical.
Let's
we got an acoustical guitar over here.
He's
going to be singing. You heard him sing already. So we're going to get ready for that. We're going to take a break. We're going to see you right back again. All right?
Yeah.
Voss Wave, baby.
This particular dance that I want to learn how to do. Everybody's doing it. The young and the old, from the north to the south, and from the east to the west. I want to know how to do it. I want to know how to hand dance. Show me how to do it. I want to know, can you teach me?
You teach me how to hand dance.
Can you show me how to do it?
I want to know how to hand dance.
Show me how to do it.
I want to know how to hand dance.
Show me, show me, show me, show me how to do it. I like the way you move. I like the way you groove.
I like the way you groove.
I like the way you spin.
I like the way you spin.
You turn around and you do it again.
I want to know, can you teach me? Can you teach me how to hand dance?
I want to know how to do it.
It's about time for me to get on the floor and stop being so lazy.
Teach me how to do it. I like the way you move.
I like the way you groove.
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 I like the way you groove. I like the way you spin.
I like the way you spin.
You turn around.
Do it again.
Do it again and again.
I want to thank y'all for tuning in right now. We got a brother Nassim Sadiq that's getting ready to give it to us right now live. He was at the table giving us a little acapella, but right now we're going to be live on the stage. He's going to sing a little bit and play a little bit. Okay, right here at Vox Wave, babe. You know what it is.
Vox Wave, thank you so much for having me today. This song right here is an original. It's on the album, which is called Singing for My Life. This is the first song on the album, and it's called This Time Around. Good to go.
Ever since the day I saw your face, I knew my troubles were erased when you looked me in my eyes and you smiled. Eventually, I got to know you more. The first time you touched me sent chills down to my bones. I've never felt so sure in my life that someone was mine, really all mine. And dream lover, you rescued me. You saved me from myself, and now I'm so happy. My conscience is clean, my mind is at ease. I fell in love with the right girl this time around. This time around, I fell in love with the right girl this time around. You make it easy to love you. Your spirit's made of gold. The sun shines from your soul. It's never a problem to go out my way, 'cause you're worth it. You're worth it. With you, all I have to be is me. It's so inspiring watching you chase your dreams. Spent so many lonely nights and days waiting just for you. No one else would do. Dream love, you rescue me. You save me from myself, and now I'm so happy. My conscience is clean, my mind is at ease. I fell in love with the right girl this time around. This time around, I fell in love with the right girl this time around. Sometimes I've gone against my morals, messing up, not listening to my gut. But life lessons gave me understanding and led me to you, a love that I could trust. Oh, dream lover, you who rescue me, yeah. You saved me from myself, and now I'm so happy. My conscience is clean, my mind is at ease. I fell in love with the right girl this time around. This time around. This time around. This time around.
Up in here today, baby. That's for sure. For sure. That was a great great performance there, bro.
Thank you.
Fell in love this time around, huh? That was the name of it? I mean, what's the name of the song?
The name of the song is This Time Around.
This Time Around. You got the right one, though. You had the right one this time around. That's what it's about.
I fell in love with the right one.
You still got the right one?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, that's what's up. You can go shout out to the right one.
What's up, baby? How you doing?
That's what's up. Yeah. We having fun in here, man. Hey, look, man. That acoustical thing, man, that was wild. I thought you was going to have some tracks or something, man, but it's always great to have original music, man. So how long have you been working on that cut right there, player?
On that song right there?
Yeah.
So I released the album Singing for My Life last April.
Okay.
I don't know exactly how long. I say it probably took about 7 months to write that song, because at first I just had like those two chords.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And then I had more of the chords, and I was trying to get the words right, and right. It was just a process. That song took a while to write.
But tell me, man, what gave you the inspiration on that song, man? Seriously.
All right, so
tell me. I know there's a story behind that song, man. Go on, tell a story, man.
So I've messed up. I've made some bad choices, mm-hmm. in regards to like relationships, and that's not just with girls. It's with some of my friends too. Right. You know what I mean? So I made a mistake in college, and I fell in love with you know, this girl that I shouldn't have fallen in love with.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So
that happens.
Yeah, you know what I mean? That it happens. When you start off on a bad foundation like that, it never works out. So when I wrote this song, I was like imagining, like, what it's going to feel like exactly when I meet the right girl. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Exactly how it's going to feel. And then it all just came together. And thank God I got the right one right now. You know what I mean? So it's just, it was a process, you know? I fell in love with the right girl this time around. That's really the whole story. Because, you know, we make mistakes and stuff like that. And
as men, we do that. We do that. So how did you meet this right girl? Man, I don't mean getting your business like that.
Right,
but how did you meet this right girl?
So I seen her in the cafeteria or whatever. She was in the cafeteria. Okay. I was like, what's good with you? I was like, how you doing? She was just beautiful. And I was like, I just saw her. And I was like, dang, like, I want to get to know her.
Right.
And then I ended up seeing her. She was working. And then we just started talking for a little bit. And then.
So when you first seen her, that's the one. When you first seen her, you know, that's the same feeling. You know, I don't want to get biblical on y'all, but you know, back in the garden, God had put Adam to sleep for years, mm-hmm. and he named all the animals in the world. He had domain on all the animals, and he said, "Well, you know, you need a mate." He put him to sleep for years, and he woke him up, and the first thing he seen was woman. And he said to God, "He said, oh my Lord, what have you brought me?" So was that kind of, when you see a attractive woman, it's almost the same feeling. It's like, woo, she is. That's the same feeling that Adam got back in the day. But I don't want to get biblical on y'all, but that's where it is sometimes.
That's the truth.
But look here, real quick. I want something else, acapella, man, because you got a beautiful voice, man. Everybody back home want to hear your voice one more again.
What's that, John? Loving you is all I need. Never take your love from me. Because I think I would lose my mind if you would go away. And so say you'll never leave my side, and that forever you'll be mine. Oh, April, shower me with your love. And yes, I'll give you all the love I have inside this heart of mine. And yes, I swear that I'll be here for you forever and all times. So if ever you feel lonely, all you have to do is call me, and I'll be there to shower you with my love.
All right, one more again, man. One more again, bro. One more again. Tell us something. Tell everybody something. How can they get a hold of you? They want to get some of your music, man. Give all your social media stuff and how to get a hold of you and get some of your music, bro.
Right. Just type in my name, Nassim Sadiq. It's the only one.
Okay.
Everything will pop up. But my Instagram is Nassim, N-A-S-I-M 714.
Okay.
And then the name of the album is Singing For My Life. It's on iTunes, Google Play, Spotify, Amazon, Tidal, iHeartRadio, wherever you listen to music online, it's there.
Right.
And then the website is srlemusic.com if you're interested in getting a hard copy sent directly to you.
Well, that's awesome, bro. That's awesome. So tell me, did you produce all your music, or you have some people working with you, or are you in the studio now? What's going on? Talk about that.
So literally today, I just finished copywriting all the material for my second album.
Okay.
In regards to the first album, I got my boy Drew Felons playing bass.
Okay.
And then I had Christopher Phillips, and he's playing the drums.
Okay.
So on the whole album, it's a 3-piece band.
Okay.
From a production standpoint, I wrote the lyrics and the guitar. And then my bassist, I gave him that, and he just took off and did his whole thing with the bass, and the drummer did the same thing with the drum. So that's That's how it all came together.
How many tracks are on this? Is this one CD right now?
Right now, it's just one CD.
Okay, how many tracks on the CD, bro?
A sweet seven.
Seven? You seven.
Nice seven.
That's a good number.
Mm-hmm. It's my favorite number.
Each day of the week, you got a song for us, basically.
I like that.
Each day of the week, you got a song for us.
I like that.
You know, exactly like I told you guys before, we are sponsored by Adel Motor Star Imports right here at 4711. And we got a brother, Mr. Sanders, in the house tonight. He got a car from Adel Motor Star Imports. What kind of car did you get, Brother Sanders?
Uh-huh.
What kind of car did you get from here?
What kind of car?
Yeah, what kind of car did you get?
Mercedes.
Oh, he got a... Ooh. Oh, Mr. Sanders, you know, he high roller. He got a Mercedes Benz from here.
Ballin'.
Ballin'. Did they bring the car... Was the car on the lot? Did they bring the car to you?
Play? On the lot.
The car was on the lot?
Mm. I'm a type of guy like this. I'm a strange shopper. Something hit me like a ton of bricks, even when it come down to clothes. I keep coming back. I got to have that.
Right.
That's just like when you saw that girl first time around.
Mm.
I mean, another time. What's the next title of the song?
This time around. Right.
We get ready to mic out Mr. Sanders. Go ahead. We micing him up as we speak. It's all good.
This time around.
Uh-huh.
You know, there are many apples on the tree. One may be a sweeter than all the rest of them, and when it come down to relationships, you don't know exactly whether this is the right one, but at some point you'll know, because it has something to do with your heart.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, look, this brother got the right one right now. We get ready to go to a break. Okay, we got Mr. Sanders in the house. We get ready to go to a break. What's your next song, bro? What's your next song we got coming up for us, bro?
The next song is another song from the album. I'm gonna do Just Enough.
Just Enough?
Yes.
Okay. That's your music, man.
Yes, sir.
We get ready to go to a break. Brother Ron, the infamous engineer, gonna take us to a break. And after the break, you see this brother performing once again right here, though. Boss Wave, baby. That's how we do it. Okay? All right.
Vox Radio, along with Then Sings My Soul Productions, is pleased to announce Wyoming Paris's Then Sings My Soul musical. The TSMS group is seeking support in our movement concerning domestic violence. This soul-stirring stage production is not to entertain, but to educate, encourage, and help eradicate this horrible disease that's plaguing women, men, and children who are affected daily in households across the world. Please join us in supporting 3-year-old Skylar Johnson's scholarship fund. Skylar's grandmother was murdered by her fiance, then leaving Skylar's mother at age 3 to be raised by her uncle and maternal grandmother. To make your tax-deductible donation to a Skylar Johnson Scholarship Fund, and for ticket information on Then Sings My Soul stage play in Brooklyn, New York on May 5th and 6th, visit thensingsmysoul.org. That's www.thensingsmysoul.org.
All right, guys, we have a dynamite artist in the studio tonight, Naseem Sadiq. For sure, he gave us the first song, and he getting ready to play his perform his next song on the Vox Wave stage. I'll get my camera, I'll get this thing recorded, man. I'm sending it to y'all later on. It's going to be up on YouTube in a little bit, for sure. We thank you guys for logging on and tuning in. Vox Wave, baby. That's how we do it right here, Vox Wave. Love this stage, man. You sounding good, brother. There's some acapella for us just a second ago, guys. This guy's dynamite, so I'm enjoying myself. I love live music. This is why we do what we do. Without further ado, brother, here we go one more again.
Okay, here we go. This one from the album Singing for My Life, and it's called Just Enough.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Yeah, 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 yeah. Just enough, giving me just enough for you, just enough for your time, just enough for your mind, just enough for your smile too. But I know that I want more. You're the one I've been searching for. Really feeling you, boo, baby. Gotta know, is my love enough for you. I'm really feeling you, baby. Gotta know, is my touch enough for you? And don't wanna overwhelm you, baby. My worst fear is you feel lonely, lady. When all my love's right here for you. I'm getting a little older now, and I'm done with the running round. And now it's time to catch my breath. But all I wanna breathe is you. To run around, explore the world with you. Oh, I'm really feeling you, baby. Gotta know, is my love enough for you? I'm really feeling you, baby. Gotta know, is my touch enough for you? I'm really feeling you, boo, baby. Gotta know, is my love enough for you? I'm really feeling you, boo, baby. Gotta know, is my touch enough for you, babe?
Just
another jam, man. That was hot. You know that song right there sounded like something else that related to your girlfriend, man. Like that's another song you wrote about with her. That, or am I wrong or right? No.
Nah, that's something different.
Okay, but break down that song for us, man.
So that one right there, you know, I was still single at the time when I wrote that.
Okay.
And I had a little crush on this girl. You know what I mean? And it was one of those things where I liked her a lot more than she liked me, and it just, you know
that,
what I'm saying?
That happens, bro.
And that's
happens.
What it was. But she kept on giving me like just enough for me to keep on pursuing her.
Just teasing her, brother, instead of
just being like, nah, leave me alone. But you know, saying she was giving me like just enough for me to keep on.
Like the
curious. You know what I mean? So yeah, that's what that was about. So
yeah, that's what's up, man. Mm-hmm. But tell me something. How long have you been playing and singing, man? Because it's like you've been playing and singing all your life, but you said you just picked it up. How long ago, man?
I've been playing and singing, doing both for like 4.5, 5 years.
Oh, that's a blessing, man. That's Amen. A blessing. You didn't know you had that gift, man. Did you play? You didn't play in the choir or the school choir? Something you was coming up in high school or something like that?
Always sang. I always sang, but never played an instrument. I took piano lessons for a little bit, but I wasn't crazy, but I didn't like it. Right. You know, with the guitar on mobile, I could bring that with me anywhere and everywhere. You know, pianos, I didn't have fun with the piano, but I love the guitar.
So where are you originally from, bro? Where's your hometown?
Upstate New York. A small, small town called Goshen.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. It's about an hour and a half north of the city. Yeah. You know, if you're from New York, if you're outside of the city, upstate, everything's upstate.
Right, right. So that's where you went to high school in New York also?
Yeah, kindergarten all the way through high school.
Did you go to school, college?
Mm-hmm. I started off at Robert Morris University out near Pittsburgh, and then I transferred back to New York, and I graduated from SUNY Albany.
Okay. So you said you had a, what, 4-5-piece band right now?
No.
How many instruments are on the album or CD again? Four pieces?
It's three pieces on the album.
Okay, so three pieces plus you, and you singing also. You got background singers on your CD?
On the very, very last song, my bassist is singing too. We're harmonizing together.
Oh, man, well, you know, you got to get them in here the next time, man. Okay. Well, how difficult is that going to be to get the group in here, man?
Nah, that shouldn't be a problem at all.
That's what's up, man. I need one more acapella, man, before you go. You know, you ain't going nowhere no time soon.
All right. Oh, so we do it again. Knowing we should quit it, but we simply won't admit it again. It feels good, but so good, we won't do it again. It's so dramatic again. After we go at it, we get mad and we go at it again. Oh, I love it, but I hate it. She's my favorite. Again, wasting time. I can't help it. She's so fine. Yes, I like her style. I love the way she talks and I smile. As much as we may try, can't quite see eye to eye. So in the meantime, I guess we'll say bye-bye.
Again. One more again. Yes, indeed.
Thank you.
So tell me, brother, who is your inspiration? What artist out there is your inspiration? Who do you like listening to, man?
Who do I love? I love so many. James Brown, Stevie Wonder, John Legend, Music Soul Child, Aretha Franklin, Anita Baker. Who else? I'm bumping that new J. Cole hard right now.
Okay.
That new J. Cole. I love that thing.
That's nice. There's
so many influences. Earth, Wind & Fire. The Average White Band.
Well, that's old school there, baby.
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of different inspirations.
Can't go wrong with
it with
a five, man.
Oh, yeah.
So when's the next time you're going to be out playing? You take your group with you, or you do a lot of stuff on solo? When's the next time you think you'll be out playing?
I'm leaving here to go to a show tonight at Twins Jazz in D.C.
Oh, yeah, Twins Lounge.
Yes.
Right on Battle for U Street.
Yeah.
Yeah, tonight. Man, they still pumping over there.
Yes, every first Sunday at Old Town Inn right in Largo, Maryland. And that's with the full band.
That's with the full band.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you got to put that out there one more again so everybody know what days you're doing again.
Okay, that's every first Sunday at Old Town Inn in Largo, Maryland. 9421 Largo Drive West. It's the new location because Old Town Inn, they have two locations, but it's at the new one.
Right.
And we're there every first Sunday.
Okay.
So it'll be me and my bassist tomorrow. We've been working hard to put on a real good show tomorrow.
So what time y'all?
Sunday, excuse me.
What time y'all start, man?
11:30 to 1:30.
11:30, 1:30. Mm-hmm. Okay, I might have to come check you out, man, if I'm in town, man. I got to come. I really love what you're doing on stage for us, man.
Thank you.
We're going to ask you to do one more song for us, or maybe two more songs. We're going to talk about that at the break. We're going to either do one more song for us or two more songs. So hope y'all enjoying this, but we are definitely enjoying this, Brother Nasim. He's doing a great job today
on
the Vox Wave Live set, man. So what did you think about the studio when you came in here, man? Tell the truth, man. Be honest.
I was so impressed.
I got to make some improvements, man. But talk to me.
I was so impressed. I walked in and I seen like the this backdrop you got, and it just looks dope. Everything is super professional, legit. I felt blessed when I walked in here. I was like, Amen. Thank you, God.
Oh Lord, I like to hear, man. I catch a lot of criticism, you know, because when you're being the boss, you're gonna catch it all.
Mm-hmm.
But it's always good every now and then to hear something positive, man. You know what I mean? Because I got 32, 35 personalities. and most everybody is fine. But you know, you got just like kids, you got people that's gonna complain about whatever.
Amen.
But you know, but
positive.
That's all good. I accept all that.
Look at this setup. You got all these cameras. You got the acoustics right. You got the
Yeah, see, musicians can appreciate things like this. Musicians can appreciate things like this. So I thank all my members and everybody that's on. But we thank you once again. We also want to thank Adele Motors for giving us the much love and support. 4711 Arth Place, Suitland, Maryland, right here. Like I said, if you don't see a car on a lot on the car, you know what I'm saying, that you might want. If you don't see it, they can order you a car. Get online, work your budget out, and get you a car and put a smile on your face like it did Mr. Sanders. Say, Mr. Sanders got a Mercedes Benz. Mm. You know what I'm saying? They got a little bit of everything out there, brother. So if you need a car, man, you need to holler at Mr. Rivers. He can take care of you. You know what I'm saying?
Awesome.
Take care of you. But we're going to take another quick break. And you see this brother again. He will be back on the live set, back on the live stage, doing one more again. And we appreciate you, man.
Thank you.
Enjoy, man. Enjoy. We're going to definitely try to come see you. Tell everybody where you're going to be in this coming weekend again, because I can't remember what you said you're going to be. But tell everybody one more again.
So if you ain't busy tonight.
Tonight, Twins Lounge.
Twins Jazz. Right in D.C. tonight. I'm heading right there with J.C. And I'm a feature artist tonight. It's going to be jazz. It's going to be smooth. It's going to be sexy. So come out tonight if you ain't busy. And then Sunday at Old Town Inn, every first Sunday at Old Town Inn in Largo, Maryland, and come get some delicious food and just listen to me and the bassist just play and just, you know, have some smooth sounds while you enjoy the drinks, food, and your company.
Hey,
sure.
We want to put a big shout out to Crescendo Entertainment. He's the one that supplies all of the artists that come through Crescendo. What's that phone number again, brother? Talk to him with that phone number. 202-498-2295. That's my man, Donovan. He can hook you up. If you need a gig or you need anybody need musicians, you can call that number right there. That brother will hook you up. He's been my main man getting the entertainment. He's brought us some dynamite entertainment in here thus far. But like I said, right now, we're going to take a break. After the break, you're going to see this brother one more time on the stage, and we're going to see y'all a little later right after the break. Go to your break right now. Thank you so much for tuning in.
TV show. Tonight's been, we had a very special guest, Nassim Sadiq. He was doing some great things. We got one more song. He's going to get out of here. He got a gig he got, so he's running right now. I wish I could keep him all night, but he said he got to go. You know what I'm saying? So without further ado, Nassim Sadiq, y'all.
Here's the
the last song on the album, and it's called Hashtag Love Matters. You guys know there's a bunch of craziness going on in the States and throughout the world. So I wrote this song right here to make a positive contribution to all the craziness. And, you know, if we want to make change, we got to start with love. So the name of the song is Hashtag Love Matters.
What's going on in the world today? I don't know what to believe. Contradictions I learn and see. Media divides, lies, and deceives. How many times must we make the same mistakes? Have we not learned from our past? Fighting a battle that's been fought before. Still don't see no freedom at last. 'Cause we forgot about love, beautiful love. We forgot about love, beautiful love. Yeah. Black, brown, white, red, they're just colors, yeah. There's only one human race. Education system teaches us our differences. With so much in common, we should relate. Hyphen separate us, we're just American. Do other countries have a box for race? Get up, get out, and travel this beautiful world. You see how much in your textbooks was fake. 'Cause we forgot about love, beautiful love. We forgot about love, beautiful love. And I know we can do better. Change has to start with some new insight. We're all so much stronger when we stand together. If we put love first, then we'll get the thing right. We all look different, but we're just human. All we get on this earth is one life. But my people are being killed for no reason. All the hate that forgot about love, beautiful love. We forgot about love, 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 beautiful love. We forgot about love, we forgot about love, we forgot about love, we forgot about love. We forgot about love, yeah. Beautiful love, beautiful love.
Yeah. Hashtag Woo. Love matters. Thank you, sir. So once again, my name is Nasim Sadiq. My Instagram is Nasim, N-A-S-I-M, 714. My website is srlemusic.com. You can find all the original music there, but it's also on iTunes, Google Play, Spotify, Amazon. As soon as you see my name, just type in my name, it'll all pop right up. But foxwave.com, thank you so much for having me. It's been an honor and a privilege to be here. Thank you again. God bless and stay positive.